Hey everybody, how's it going? Welcome back. I'm so glad you're here. Thanks for clicking on the channel. Hey, I'm going to do something I think is kind of fun. I hope you find it interesting and just it's kind of a curious thing to me. As you see, we are going to look at a video from what is it? Best Zangers. I did one yesterday from this series here of Florianson singing Shadows, which was awesome. But this one here is featuring Henk Poort, I believe, is pretty close. Excuse me if I'm not pronunciating that correctly. And I clicked on it for a second just to see what it was. And then as soon as I heard it, it sparked a memory of because he's doing Sound of Silence, which is, of course, a cover of Paul Simon, you know, and Art Garfunkel's Sound of Silence from, gosh, I guess it was the early 70s. And when I heard it, I only listened to it just for a second. But then, boom, it sparked something. So I want to play another video after it, not to say that they're alike. It just reminded me of the quality that that he's putting into this song as a cover. It sounded really good to me, and I'm hoping that I'm sure it will continue to sound really good as I go through the whole thing. But I want to show you something else afterwards. So stick around for two songs in this video. We're just going to kind of play them side by side just for fun. And then we'll talk more about it and the reasons why I'm doing it. So let's check this one out. The Sound of Silence from Henk Poort, I believe his name is. I've seen him. I've seen him in several things, of course. Several videos that I've done over the past few weeks, so I recognize his face, and that's why I'm excited to kind of do this, because I know he's a popular man, and he's very well known in in parts of the world. So let's check it out.
Hello darkness, my old friend.
That's all I heard. And when I heard his voice, I was like, oh, man.
I come to talk with you again. Because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was sleeping. And the vision that was planted in my brain still dreams. I walked alone.
She loves it.
Narrow streets of cobblestone.
I do too.
Neath the halo of a high street lamp, I turn my collar to the cold and damp. When my eyes were stabbed by the flash of a neon light. Let's play it the night and touch the sound of silence.
What an amazing
and
voice.
In the naked light I saw 10,000 people, maybe more. People talking without speaking.
Wow.
People hearing without listening. People writing songs that voices never shared.
Amazing.
And no one dare disturb the sound of silence. Fools that I don't know.
little grit in his voice. I like that. Listen, wow.
Take my arms and I might reach you, but my words like silent raindrops fell and echoed in the wells of silence, and the people bowed and prayed.
Excellent. Wow. Okay, so I expected it to be very powerful, and even though I didn't know exactly how it was gonna come across, and it exceeded my expectations. His vocals, the way he made that song his own, I expected him to do that. I don't know. Because I've heard him before, I've heard him sing, and I've seen him perform, and I know he is, I would say he's an iconic figure. I don't think I'm mistaken by saying this man is an iconic figure in music, and he's got a voice that is extremely well-trained, and he executes probably anything he sings excellently. And the way he sang that song and the power behind his voice and then the grit behind it, you know, he totally took an iconic song, you know, especially in America, you know, the United States. I don't know how, I'm sure that song's around, it goes around, because I've been in other countries where I've been playing on stage and people would hand me pieces of paper with requests on them, and they would ask for Simon and Garfunkel music. So I know that Simon and Garfunkel is, you know, a worldwide band at one point, very well known. And so it's an iconic song, and he made it, you know, his own. He definitely did that song justice, and he did himself justice. And it's so refreshing to see, especially from an older man, you know, that has got lots of experience behind him, years and years of practice and talent and knowledge, and then to express himself in front of a very much younger panel. You know, would you agree? I mean, the rest of that panel is much younger than him. I don't know how old he is, but he looks like he's in, you know, maybe his early 70s. I don't know. Maybe it's hard to tell. But, you know, he's not in his 30s. And some of those guys look like kids, like in their 20s. So his audience is blown away by him, that panel, you know. Okay, so let me get to my point. So the next video I want to do, and so all that being said, is I want to show you another song. You may have heard this before, I don't know, but this is something that was that came out years ago, and it is, let me get it ready here. It's a Johnny Cash song, and it is a version of a Nine Inch Nails song called Hurt. And Johnny Cash is also, whoops, that's not what I want to do, is also an iconic figure as far as a singer and a performer. Very iconic man. And he takes this song that was done by 9-inch nails, which is kind of like a, you know, sort of a an electronic metal electronic sort of band. And he makes this song his own. He takes it to a different level and brings the same kind of passion as Hank did to Sound of Silence to this song called Hurt. So let me just play it for you and you tell me if it was a fun experiment or not. Okay, let's check it out.
I hurt myself today to see if I still feel. I focus on the pain, the only thing that's real. The needle tears a hole, the old familiar sting. Try to kill it all away, but I remember everything. What have I become? My sweetest friend, everyone I know goes away in the end. And you could have it all, my empire of dirt. I will let you down, I will make you hurt.
You stay the hell away from me, you hear?
Absolutely.
I wear this crown of thorns upon my liar's chair, full of broken thoughts I cannot repair. Beneath the stains of time, the feelings disappear. You are someone else, I am still right here. What have I become? My sweetest friend, everyone I know goes away in the end. And you could have it all, my empire of dirt. I will let you down, I will make you hurt. If I could start again, a million miles away, I would keep myself, I would find a way.
All right. Johnny Cash. So, just before his, he did this song just not too much before his passing several years ago. Now, don't get me wrong. I'm not comparing their voices. Okay. They have totally different styles of voices, completely. That's not what we're doing here, you know? But the impact, that they had on both of those songs was quite drastic. I feel like when I heard that Johnny Cash song, and when most people heard that Johnny Cash song come out, people were like, oh my gosh, you know that song, in a completely different light, and he made that song his own, and he did it in such a way that it brought it across in like a totally different nature. And I feel like Hank did that same thing. I knew he was going to do that because I could tell it was this, the first line out of his mouth. It was so powerful, and the tone and the quality reminded me of this, of Johnny Cash's song here, just enough to kind of think. And then so I kind of prepared it, not even seeing the first video ever, kind of was going to compare it, and I was right. I think that he did a great job making that Sound of Silence, Hank did, of his own. And I think Johnny Cash did the same thing. Quite remarkable career Johnny had, and I'm sure Hank has had a remarkable career as well. I'm not as familiar with him, of course, but obviously I know that he's a pretty iconic figure in the world. So I just thought I'd have a little fun with that, and I just kind of play those two back to back and just show what can be done musically with some iconic songs, with some kind of musicians and singers that can take it, take something and twist it around and make it their own in such a unique way. And that was really cool on both of those artists. It was just fun. I just wanted to do that. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you never heard either one of those songs before, I'm sure you have. I hope you enjoyed those. But let me know what you think. And just meet me down in the comments and we'll talk about it if you want. I'm not making comparisons between the two artists at all, as far as their vocal abilities and all that kind of stuff. You know, Johnny has his voice, and Hank obviously is a fabulous, well-trained singer as well, or even probably a much better singer technically than Johnny. But of course, Johnny has an iconic voice as well. All right. Well, we'll see you guys later. Thank you so much for watching my videos. I sure do appreciate it. I'm having a great time, and I hope you're having a great time joining me on these videos. Let me know what you think down in the comments. We'll see you there. Take care now.